Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in the previous sessions we have seen the OSI reference models and the TCP/IP reference model. So in this session we will see the another concept of computer networks, that is transmission medium. See, the basic layer of OSI reference model is a physical layer, when we have seen that in physical layer the bits will be transmitted from source to destination, that means the raw bits will be transmitted from source to destination through the transmission medium. So here the transmission medium is used to transfer the bits from source to destination. So how many types of transmission mediums will be there, and we have to choose one among these transmission medium to transmit the bits from one system to another system, right? So now we'll categorize this transmission medium. So this is categorized in two ways. One is guided, another one is unguided. Guided transmission medium and unguided transmission medium, right? So the name itself indicates guide and unguided. So this is wired and that is wireless. This is wired medium, this is wireless medium. Okay, so coming to this guided, again it is classified into different categories. The one is twisted pair. Twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optics. Fiber optics. Right? So these are all the wide transmission medium. And this is a wireless. So this is again divided into three categories. One is radio waves, microwaves, infrared. Okay, so these are all the wireless medium, so there will be no wire. And coming to this twisted pair, the name itself indicates here we will be having two copper wires, so separately insulated, and these are in a twisted format. So what's the purpose of two wires? So one wire is for transmitting the data and the second wire is for ground. So these wires will be twisted manner. So because with the help of this twisted manner, it will reduce the noise and the crosstalk over the data in the wire, in the cable. So that's why these two copper wires will be in a twisted manner in order to reduce the noise and crosstalk. Right. So this twisted pair is again classified into shielded, unshielded. Shielded twisted pair and unshielded twisted pair. So this is called STP, shielded twisted pair. This is called UTP, unshielded twisted pair. See here, this is coming to this unshielded twisted pair. So there will be two wires, so as we have discussed, just two wires, one is for data, another one is for ground, and both are will be in a twisted manner. So the expensive is also very less, and it is also very easy to install, right? So and the data is low, the data rate is low, so the transmission of data from one system to another system, the data rate will be low for this unshielded twisted pair. And coming to this shielded twisted pair,
it is also a pair of copper wires in a twisted manner, and again these cables will be shielded with, enclosed with one mesh or some foil, right? So that is nothing but another drum. Okay, so here the cable, the twisted pair will again enclosed with a mesh. Here there will be no mesh. Okay, so this, the data rate will be high as well as the expensive when compared to this unshielded twisted pair. And also it is somewhat difficult to install by using these shielded twisted pair cables when compared to the unshielded twisted pair cables, right?
So see, I will show you a simple thing. So unshielded twisted pair, let us take this as a cable.
This is a twisted pair cable, unshielded twisted pair. So there is no shield. Okay. So this is nothing but one cable. And coming to this one, see, so this is a foil. So twisted pair, again it is enclosed with this foil or a mesh. Here there is no foil or mesh, directly the cables will be there, right? So this is all about this shielded twisted pair and unshielded twisted pair. So the mainly these twisted pair cables are used earlier in a telephone lines. Right, so in a telephone lines or a LAN cables and all these things in earlier days, right? So coming to this coaxial twisted pair, sorry, coaxial cables. So here again, this is a copper cable shielded with metal shielding, enclosed with a metal shielding, designed to provide the immunity against noise and this data. Crosstalk. So here we are using the twisted pair. So we are twisting the cables in order to reduce the noise and crosstalk. But here we are not twisting the cable, but we are enclosing these copper wires with a metal shield, which acts as a ground. Okay. See. So this is a coaxial cable. This is a coaxial cable, right? So this is a metal shielding. Outer insulation. This is a insulation. And this is a copper wire. This is a copper wire. Okay, so this is a coaxial cable. So here also we are reducing the noise and crosstalk, but with the help of metal shielding. But here we are reducing the noise and crosstalk with the help of twisting the cables, by twisting the cables. Right? So here also it can transmit the data in a long distance, right, with a high data rate. Here also the data rate is high, and the data can be sent, the data can be sent in with through a long distance. Okay, right. So coming to this fiber optics,
coming to this fiber optics, so it is completely use of glass, and here we can use this in a cable TV cables. Okay, cable TV. Okay, cable TV network. Using a cable TV network or a telephone network. Now, then coming to this fiber optics, the fiber optics is completely of a glass, which is used as a waveguide to transmit the light signal from one system to another system. Right? So this is completely, the medium is a glass. It's not a cable, it's a glass. So through the glass, the data will be sent. So here also there are two layers. For this fiber optics also, there are two layers of a glass. The first one is called a core, which is used to transmit the data. The second one is cladding, just like our shield, metal shield. It's a cladding. The upper layer of this core is a cladding. Okay. So, with the help of this one, the data will be transferred through this glass. Okay. So, it can be done in two ways. One is a single mode and multi-mode. The fiber optics can be implemented in single mode. So single mode and multi mode. So here the name itself indicates single mode means only single data mode can be sent, and multi mode means at a time the multiple modes of light can be propagated. Right. So this is the different modes of fiber optics. So this is also used in lamps. Okay, cables, etc. Right? Then, coming to this wireless unguided, that means unguided transmission media, that is a wireless media. First one is a radio waves. So, these radio waves, this is mainly used in multicasting. Multicasting means only one sender will be there and multiple receivers will be there, right? So the data will be propagated in all the directions without any security. So any receiver can receive the signal from the radio waves. So the best use or best example for this radio waves is FM radio. So through the signal, any receiver can catch the signal and they can use the data. So this is called, this is mainly used in multicasting. One sender and multiple receivers. One sender and multiple receivers. Right. So coming to these microwaves, this is again differentiated into two categories. So one is terrestrial microwaves and satellite microwaves. Terrestrial and satellite. So the difference between these two is completely depends upon the range. So within the limited range, we will use this terrestrial microwaves, and within the large range, so wide range, we can go with the satellite. So best example for the satellite microwaves is our mobile network, right? So the data can be sent. So weather report, weather forecasting also comes under this satellite microwaves. Okay. So these are all comes under this microwaves. And coming to this infrared, so this is for communicating over a short ranges. So if we want to communicate over limited range or short range, we'll go with the infrared rays. That means example, so sharing the files from one mobile to another mobile. So that must be kept in a limited range so that the data can be transferred from one mobile to another mobile. So that is one example for this infrared, and also TV remote operation. So the TV, if you want to, I mean, operating the TV remote, so the channels will be changing, the volume will be changing, and all this will be done with the help of this infrared waves. So that is nothing but here we are not using any type of wires. So that's why it is called as a wireless transmission media, that is also called as unguided. So we are not guiding. Ok
Okay, so directly the receiver will receive this infrared signals or a microwaves or a radio waves. So one among these transmission medium, the raw bits will be transferred from one system to another system in physical layer. Right? So hope you understood. The transmission medium is of two ways. One is guided and unguided, wired and unwired. So coming to this guided, there are three categories. One is a twisted pair, coaxial and a fiber optics. Right? So twisted pair. So one final aim of all these things is to reduce the noise and the crosstalk. So for that purpose, here we are using the cables will be twisted, and here we are using the metal shielding, and here we are using the glass with the two layers. One is for the core and another one is cladding. And coming to this unguided, we'll go with the radio waves, microwaves and infrared waves. Right? So hope you understood this one. A simple explanation of transmission medium. So if you are having any doubts regarding this transmission medium, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section, so that definitely I will try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my session, like my session, share my session with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.